people just seem to gain a lot of respect for you when you pull into the races with a nice rig, and they've seen you in magazines and stuff.
I used to have a dragster just like that one right there. I used to go to the races and watch guys like I'm watching myself, or doing what I'm doing myself, and dreaming of someday having a big fuel dragster or something. And I ran small cars, and then now I make over $100,000 a year racing honey cars. So these fellas can do quite well if they keep at it and if they try hard enough.
One of a series of racing specials is brought to you by the people in your town who bottle Coca-Cola. It's the real thing, Coke.
It's a fabulous piece of machinery.
Well, it looks pretty good for a speed vehicle. I'd say it ought to get out and go.
It's really a cool looking car. I can't say too much else.
I'd love to build something like that. I got an uncle that does stuff like that, too.
Oh, yeah. I mean, anyone would like to have one, I suppose. Anyone. I mean, they're exciting, very exciting.
I like the way the cars are shaped, because people can identify with that car, with what they drive on a normal street. I identify very well with these things, and they're my favorites.
I don't know. I like to go out and see them more.
This is the story of Don Prudhomme and Tom McEwen, two of the best drag racers in the world. In match races, week after week, they drive what they call funny cars, 1,500 horsepower machines. They look something like what we drive in the street, but perform in an entirely different way.
This Mongoose Snake match race has been very popular for years, and that's what we're doing most of the time around the country. What we do is we'll go to a track, and of course they'll pit us against each other, which always makes for a real good competition, because I think he and I try harder against one another than we do against anybody else. We're good friends and everybody gets along good, but when it comes to racing, it doesn't mean as much to anybody as it does he and I. And people don't realize that a lot of times. They'll come up to you and they'll say, well, is it, you know, how are you doing for the season? Are you even, or did he beat you, or did you beat him, or something? And or is it your turn to win? And we say, well, our turn to win. You know, they don't seem to realize that we practically blow the engines right out of the car to beat each other. And you get a set amount of money to come in and make three runs, and it has nothing to do with whether you win or you lose. And yet he and I will destroy thousands of dollars worth of equipment and go in the hole for that day of racing just to beat the other guy. I can remember times like 5-6 years ago when we were racing dragsters only, and we had match races, that we've got into predicaments where we didn't speak to each other for 2 months. I mean, it has been that bad.
Don Prudhomme and Tom McEwen have reached kind of a special plateau in this wild sport of drag racing. They've been in it long enough to feel at home in whatever they do here, wherever they happen to be racing. But they're also professional enough to know that at over 200 miles an hour, the speed they reach at the end of a quarter mile, they have to be thinking, changing, and creating something new for the cars and the way they drive them every run, every weekend. And always borrowing, jiving, heckling each other. This is the game they play.
How do you know how tight it is?
I tight it the same every week.
Just by feel?
I got some mushrooms, Ron Corcoran.
No wonder you guys do so bad.
What are you doing now with the strap?
Putting the blanket, the safety blanket, back on the transmission. It's just in case the transmission was to break or explode, the blanket contains it.
This here track is a small track that we don't normally run on every day of the week or weekend, and it's awfully bumpy. It's got two lanes down here, which in a way it's safe, in other ways it isn't, because you get your wheel in this grass and it gets awfully slippery.
Actually, we have no.
Of course, we'll use this. We'll use this Christmas tree right here, and I hope we'll use an Insta Green, which means they eliminated all this these blinking light things that used to be a very popular thing.
But
the track is, the pavement looks good, so we'll be able to run pretty fast. I wouldn't drive one of those for nothing.
Well, maybe double A, two backers.
Back
here to the driveway, and it should be quite a show, so pop on out here.
This particular Saturday night for Don and Tom is the Mid-America Dragway at Muncie, Indiana. The sun is gone, the cars have come out to run under the lights. To make things go quicker from the start, they brush rosin over the asphalt to help the tires grab on the green light that'll send them on the way. They're both ready for the first of three match races.
This is your big chance. Don't blow it.
It's staging time for Don and Tom.
A spectator that would ever want to know the thrill or the acceleration of a car, it's about twice as fast as a jet airplane taking off from a landing field.
It's like that, but maybe 50 times stronger. Or if you've ever been on a roller coaster, you come to that real first bad hill, you know, that goes straight down, and you think your body isn't going to stay up with it. It's something like that.
There's a lot of noise, and there's a lot of vibration in the car. It shakes. There's a great deal of driving involved.
Not having parachuted or free fall, a lot of guys say that that's a lot like it, too.
That's what the crowd loves. Noise and tire smoke and the fire from the engine exhaust. This is what the millions of fans at drag strips across the country come to see and to be part of. The Dome takes the first heat. At 193 miles an hour.
Don, how did the run go?
It was terrible. We're up 1,000 feet here in altitude, which I wasn't aware of. And the fuel mixture wasn't right. It ran decent, but next run will run much better, because now we made a run on the motor. You know what the spark plugs look like, we're just going to hop it up.
Second heat goes to Perdome at 199.
He's got about 92% nitro, and I think I've got about 80 in mine. And they're both rich, and his makes more fire like that. I think he does it to light his way because he's getting to be old, and that way he can see where he's going.
We may not be able to match race again if I keep beating you like this. You know that?
The snake. Does it a third time and beats Tom McEwen in the noise and heat of the summer night. 4 Perdome and McEwen, drag racing is a gypsy way of life. From town to town, state to state. From Saturday night in Muncie, they caravan to a Sunday day meet in Michigan. This is the other side of match racing.
How far is it to Ann Arbor?
55 miles.
55 miles.
Hour 75.
The humidity.
You have no idea whatsoever.
Okay. Thank you. Okay, Smiley. Tom McKinnon, he's a lot of fun. Good buddy. I imagine he's about one of my closest friends. And not a real hard racer, though. That's one thing him and I've always battled about. And he's got a good equipment, and he runs hard, but he doesn't really give it the all-out thing. He's a very good promoter, but as far as being the all-out racer, I don't know. I don't think he is. Maybe I just want to win a little bit harder than him. People often ask me that because the majority of the time our car usually comes out on top. I guess maybe I just want to win more than him. Maybe it's more important to me. He's very interested in girls, and because he's single, and alligator shoes. And diamond rings, and I'm interested in good superchargers and things like that, so I guess that makes a difference.
This is the scene that surrounds Don Prudhomme and Tom McEwen. Precision drag machines that make up a total of 8 major eliminator categories in the National Hot Rod Association, the world's largest auto racing sanctioned body. It began in 1951 and today includes top fuel and gas, funny cars, pro stocks, competition eliminators, modified, super stock, and stock. It's a nationwide pastime that draws more than 5 million spectators in a single season.
Come on, sunshine, what can you show me? Where can you take me to make me understand? When the wind can shake me, brothers forsake me, and the rain can touch me, can I touch the rain?
Milan Dragway, the strip at Ann Arbor, looks like a washout. It's been raining here for hours, and not far away there are tornado warnings. There's one thing you don't do in drag racing, and that's run on a wet track. There's not much to do, but just hope that it'll clear. If it doesn't, you get paid part of your show money and move on.
They said, and I said, well, you know, I said, it's raining all around. He said, well, they just called the airport, and they said that it's going to clear up, and I'm standing there getting soaked, and I said, yeah, you're right. I said, in about a week. You guys got any Hot Wheel cars?
Yeah.
Huh?
Yeah,
how many?
I got 50 of them.
You got the Mongoose and Snake?
Yeah.
How come you got the Snake? Which one's the fastest?
Snake.
Hey, that's what I wanted to hear.
Why do you make up stuff like that?
You hear that, didn't you?
You paid those kids to say that.
Come on, sunshine, what can you show me? Where can you take me to make me understand? The wind can shake me, brothers forsake me, the rain can touch me, but can I touch the rain? So much.
Luck's on everybody's side. The rain's passed, the cars are ready for their first run. Tom, the mongoose, McEwen, turns the tables from last night and beats Prudhomme on his first run.
Ron, what happened on the last run? The tires apparently gone away. We've got too many runs on them, and the track was slippery, and the clutch was too tight. We had to change tires, and it changed the clutch, lighten the clutch up a little bit.
They're going to switch us around now and run us against two local boys, see if they can blow us off, because our car's not running real good. So we'll go up, and Don will run Connie Coletta. I'll run that Super Duster Plymouth.
We unload the car off the truck and we warm it up and get it all ready for the race. We mix the fuel, whatever percentage we're going to run, like we run around 80-85% nitromethane and the rest methanol or alcohol. I put this fire suit, which is made out of Nomex and Kynol, which is about 5 or 6 layers. And I have special boots, special Nomex underwear. I have a padded hood that I put over my head that is like 5-6 layers thick. And then the helmet. The face mask has a special breathing apparatus built right into it with some filters that you breathe through that keep the fumes, the nitro fumes, and also fire or anything else getting into your lungs. I bring the car up to the point my mechanic will stop me. He'll pour down the liquid traction, rosin or whatever you're using, burn out of the rosin and go out with which is the burnout you see, which is all the smoke and everything. And that does two things. That gets the tires hot, and that also gets the rubber from the tire on the pavement, which makes the two surfaces the same, which bonds them together, which gives you better traction. Then we back up in our tracks. We come back up and we stage, both cars get ready, and then we put out the staging lights, and you wait for your light to come on, and as soon as you see the light, then it's reaction time, and you go, and I run at about 300 or 400 feet, and I shift the car, and at the first light down there, which is the top speed light, I pull the parachute there so the car drives away from the pilot chute. And you go through the lights, then you let off the throttle, push the fuel shutoff off, turn the engine off, and if everything goes like it's supposed to, you have no problem.
Power 5 will be gone. And now, the Snake. Running again, Connie Coletta in his Wait for the power. Logie chassis. Mustang body style. Complete black motor and
I'm very uptight, but at the whole time when I get to the races, the time I pull into the gate, I get very, very uptight. I'm nervous. I'm scared to death always of getting beat, and I don't care who I'm racing, whether it's McKeown or anyone else. I just don't eat or nothing. It's a great deal of concentration on the lights and when to shift the car. The car has a two-speed transmission in it, how to shift it at the right time so you don't start the tire smoking. If you overwind, it'll start the tire smoking. There's a great deal of concentration in getting down towards the finish light. When you see the first light come up, you know, three lights down there. As the first one comes up, you have to get ready for the shoot and hit it at the right time so it blossoms and stops the car and get the car to a safe stop.
So far, we've beaten Prudhomme and the Super Duster. Prudhomme has beaten Coletta. Coletta has beaten the Super Duster. So this round, if I beat Coletta, then we win. Coletta beats me, then that means he only has been beat one time. If Prudhomme wins this time, he'll just have been beaten once. So that could make, if I lose and Prudhomme and Coletta both win, then it will be a three-way tie for first. But don't worry about that happening. I'll see that that don't happen. That's too confusing for everybody. We'll get a headache thinking about it.
Don?
Yeah?
Made your second run of the day. How's car running now that you've made the adjustment?
It's running better. It's still not right. It's still wanting to smoke the tires off the start line, which you lose, you know. A great deal of elapsed time, which is, of course, wins the race. And it should run a little better next time. I lost my brake down there that time, though. I gotta figure out what that is. What's happening, or whatever. I hope I didn't puncture a brake line. If it wasn't for this parachute, I'd have been in serious trouble.
After making that first run and going up in smoke, as I was listening to the engine, I knew what I had to do for the next round, even before I took my foot out of it. It's just one of those things that comes to you. It's just like reading music. I guess you know, if you know, when you're playing an instrument, if you hit a bad note, you know why or something. Well, it's the same way with the race car when it's in smoke. We took counterweight off the clutch. We pulled the spark advance back in the engine to kill the low-end horsepower. We put a different compound of tires on the car, made a little bit of fuel adjustment, made a jet change in the engine, all this in one run. A lot of guys wouldn't do that. They just change the tires. Well, let's try that again. But you can't do that because I was off so far, I just couldn't come back and drop a tenth. I had to drop a whole bunch, close to a second.
I don't blow your drawers off.
How can you do that to me? I'm a guest. I'm a visitor. You live here. Be nice.
Hey, I know. It's just the same thing I get when I come to California. Dill, instant dill, right? Come on, Pink, put more in it.
You got a pink oil filter and everything on here. I mean, that's it, right? You make a long one and a short one, right?
That's
true. We'll do the same.
Okay.
Try to be ready, okay?
Yeah.
When I woke this morning, something inside of me told me this would be my day. I heard the morning train, I felt the wind change. Too many times I'm on my way. Come on, sunshine. What can you show me? Where can you take me to make me understand? The wind can shake me, brothers, God save me, the rain can touch. touch me? Can I touch the rail? And then I saw the sunrise above a cotton sky, like a candy, candy light. I saw the milkman, I saw the businessman, I saw the only road in sight. Then I got to thinking.
During the afternoon, the snake and mongoose match racing has taken in the local funny car competition also. Tom McEwen won the meet. And Don Prudhomme set a new track record. It looks pretty easy, but listening to Don and Tom tell about it, it's a long road to get to the top.
You don't necessarily have to come out and jump right in the AA classes right off. Work yourself up to it. You don't have to come out and race for the money. People can come out and run for the trophies and have a good time and bring the family out and just go out and do it. They've got tracks all over the United States, 200 or 300 of them now. They even run on Wednesdays and Friday nights for grudge racing. There's no reason for kids to street race anymore.
It's not so much, that's not so much the way anymore. The kid takes his mom's car out to the races. It used to be that way when money was tighter and so on. When I was coming up, that was kind of the way it was. You'd borrow the family car and take it to the drag races. It's changed a great deal. Kids nowadays seem to have more money and they have their own cars at the drag races by the time they're old enough to drive.
We have done stuff that engineers in Detroit told us wouldn't work. And now they just shake their heads, and now they've incorporated a lot of that stuff into the new cars. So you've really got to get everything together, you know, because it's a far-out thing, you know, and it's, again, you'd have to come out and see it to appreciate it, you know. It's not a kid's thing, and yet it is.
It's a whole way of life for Don Prudhomme and Tom McEwen. It's moving down the road, town after town, state after state, making life good. Getting it on to the next match race. Match Race, one of a series of racing specials, has been brought to you by the people in your town who bottle Coca-Cola. It's the real thing, Coke.